you know, getting to do this arc as Ursula is, you know, it's just been unbelievable. And to work with Victoria Smurfit and Kristen Bauer, I mean, the whole group has been, everybody at Once Upon a Time, it's a really amazing team. And they work hard. They make like a movie in 10 days, you know. But particularly because I got to work with these girls so closely, they're so brave and funny and smart. And, you know, we just had, it was like the, you know, supernatural Charlie's Angels. We just had a ball.
How do you think your character adjusted to working in an aquarium for 20 years?
Oh, she didn't like that at all, you know, but those are her babies. We had a whole, like, some of it got cut, but in the first episode where I worked with John and the director, and, you know, he was like, those are your children, you know, and, like, all those, I loved how they set that whole, you know, space up. It was just like, these are my children, and I get to be with them. So as much as, like, she didn't like shoveling, you know, fish shit and all that sort of thing, she still got to be with her people, you know, and, you know, it just made sense. Sadly, Ursula got her happy ending, you know. Sorry to spoiler on in England.
You got your voice back.
I did. I got my voice back. So, but the good news about, you know, Once Upon a Time is that nobody dies, you know, and nobody stays happy for too long. So hopefully I'll be able to resurface in that world.
What would you like to see if you do come back to the show? What would you like to happen?
You know, I just would like to be utilized as a way that, like, when they need something, you know, handled, like she's like the fixer. You know, she's the town fixer, you know, whether it's like for good or for ill, you know, you call on her for, you know, I think that would be kind of fun to just be of service.
Would you like to see your character revert back to being a mermaid or staying as a tentacled-like creature?
I think tentacled-like creature, because then you can do more things, you know, like mermaid, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, it's pretty and whatever, but like, you know, that, you know, my tentacled beast can, she can take care of stuff. She can reach things. She can slap people. It's good. Who doesn't want that skill? You know, I think that, well, you look at Disney, all the interesting characters are women. You know, and for the most part in those, you know, Disney stories and the fairy tales, you know, it's that they're the protagonists and then they're the protagonists and they're also the villains. So you're already given that service, you know. But we're lucky on Once Upon a Time, you know, the writers are so, you know, Robert and I mean, I'm sorry. I was thinking about something else. They have created these beautiful women and these beautiful characters that are so fun to watch. And then you've got Lana and Ginny and, you know, Jennifer there who bring to life these, you know, they fill it, you know. But people love the villains the most. They love Robert, people like flip out, you know, if you say anything about Lana Paria. Like they just fall apart because she's just this majestic creature, you know, and it's in life and in, you know, art, she is that. But I was happy to be a part of that.
What do you love to see brought into that world moving forward?
Wow, I mean, I feel like they've literally, you know, mined that, you know, well, deep. So I you're asking a very jet-lagged lady, I would have to think about who, you know, but like, you know, I was surprised they were able to bring Ursula in there, you know, like in the way that they did. It's, you know, I just feel lucky.
How about Woody from Toy Story? That could be an interesting one.
It would be really interesting how, you know, and I don't know how they would do that. Oh my God, is my partner in crime's here, my girlfriend! Come here! Don't make me do this by myself!